It does have a really special charm. It's a bit of a hidden gem, really, but it's beautiful. It's set here on the estuary. There's some lovely hotels, restaurants, beautiful food to be had. Lovely little bijou, bespoke, independent traders in the town. So you can always find that little special gift as well. It's got some beautiful and interesting pieces of architecture that you can enjoy. It's a bit of a playground, you know, you can hire your own self-hire boat trips, you can take guided walks around the area. There's a beautiful little trip across to Pole Ruin, just a 5-minute trip, but you know, that's something magical.
Fowey can be really family friendly, especially during the summertime during regatta. There's a lot of events aimed at the kids. It's also got a lovely kind of sense of community. I think the key parts of Fowey's outstanding natural beauty are the view from the Hall Walk, which is if you go over the ferry at Bidinnick and you can do a nice long walk around to Pole Ruin. That view for me is one of the most beautiful views in the whole country, really.
Daphne du Maurier, who most people would know by her books Rebecca, Jamaica in My Cousin Rachel, lived and wrote in this area. In fact, the house just over my shoulder here, Ferryside, the Cream and Blue House, is the house in which she lived and wrote her first novel, The Loving Spirit. The Fowey Festival of Words and Music takes place each year in the early part of May over 10 or 11 days.
The comparison is not all that unfair when you reflect...
The festival has such a wonderful breadth of performers coming. We've got plenty of authors and politicians. We have the guided walks and the boat trips as well. And in the evening, well, fantastic music, so we're able to let our hair down.
It's one of those places where if you come to once, you're going to come to again.